Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another Propagandacast. With me, your host, Imperial Dane. We are off here to a 1v1 on Langaraskaya. Yes, indeed, Langaraskaya again. We just had another patch yesterday. That is from when I'm recording it. So all of a sudden, again, my replay archive got wiped. So that leaves me with rather precious little choice here. And sort of what to cast will be watching here. Cruzz fighting for the Soviet Union and the 76th Rifle Corps here. Cruzz, an inventive Soviet player with Guard Rifle mechanized support and terror tactics. Also noting amongst his bulletins are in fact some more accuracy bonuses for his penal troopers. Versus him shall be Captain Obvious with elite troops, spearhead and close air support. Fighting for the Reich's finest Soldaten, rolling out under the banners of the 2nd SS Panzer Division, Das Reich. Yes? And noting here in Grenadier first, then an MG42, rather interesting sort of opening there with the 3rd Grenadier following up here. In terms of bulletins, a few there for machine guns, noticing here in fact they increase accuracy. Thus, we know overall he gets 5% accuracy on his heavy machine guns. So that's definitely also interesting to note here. We also know here some early wiring going up here by the old tractor there. Starting it, so I was all Schleppen Ost, something like that, anyways. With a bit of barbed wire there. More barbed wire up there, looks like he's being very thorough with it. Well, he's taking the point, anyways. In fact, rushing for the munitions point there. Cruzz moving up there. Cruzz having rushed back for the special rifle command. Lacking to get some of those Strafniki. MG42 sending up there, Grenadiers advancing. Vorwärts, Meneo. Cruzz moving down the right flank, points there being secured. Special life command is up. Strafniki on the way. More barbed wire up there. He seems to be utterly possessed by a barbed wire demon. Or something like that, anyways. Stahlgedracht. Wir brauchen immer mehr Stahlgedracht. We're noting here that a few early mines up here to sort of protect against a quick flank up there on the victory point. Good. From Cruzz there, MG40 here finding a way. Conscript there, pulled back sufficiently enough, but we are seeing a Conscript put hit in the flank. And in fact, he's opening up that flank even more here. Captain Obvious makes a obvious mistake. Since usually, there's quite a tendency there for Conscript to rush in from there. Thankfully, due to the fact he's gone for the Strafniki, and thus the Special Command, he didn't have an early mortar. There we go, in fact, again, the mistake here that Obvious made. Has resulted in his MG40 getting pushed back. He needs to fully retreat. That Strafniki moving up. And we are seeing a scout car following up on this. At the same time, Cruzz moving up. They might encounter this Grenadier, who have not been here. So in fact, we are seeing here that Captain Obvious spilling a suit for the second MG40 opening up on the Conscript, immediately tearing into them and doing a bit of damage there, forcing them away. Grenadier's moving up, following up. And we are noticing here a bunker up for Captain Obvious. Noting here that this is a less than obvious spot for a bunker. And also noting, it's not in his base. Could it be a forwards medic bunker, which you see some do? Or could it be, say, a command bunker? Then it is Punny's under fire. Gun is on the point there. MG42 sneaking forwards. MG42 is heading over there to have support. The gun is there over. And there we go, Strafniki moving. And we're seeing a flame from up the ROX 3. Shaped a bit like a rifle. In fact, the ROKS-2, in fact, even had the flamethrower tank sort of disguised as a backpack. Sort of make it even look less conspicuous, but then with the 3rd version, they sort of will, you know, once they see it shoot flames, it might as well not matter. There we go. Strafniki there with a flamethrower. MG4 holding up here. Oh, that's going to be a problem there. Scout car running straight at it, taking light damage. There we go, force retreat. Bad situation there, Strafniki also joining in with their 2D40, he's besides the flamethrower. Could see that MG42 get wiped down the retreat. Meanwhile, finding that going in for the cutoff on there. Well played. Nice assault there from Cruzz overall. MG42 crew members getting utterly murdered there. Now that lost the MG42 there. You have Kelvax filling out the troops that far. MG42 getting in versus Conscript holding up. Pioneers holding up nearby near the command bunker as well. MG42 sees for the Rodina. Strafniki apparently suffered a few losses here nonetheless. I wonder to what though. Apparently someone just slipped and broke their neck. Ah, Yuri, he was always clumsy. They've opened up on us! Why ended up in the penal battalion in the first place? Cruzz there coming in fire, MG42 moving in, and he's moving in, and of course again staying within proximity to the MG command bunker, so they can force right here. There we go. allows him to maintain a stronger position here by the center. Upon that being secured, and then needs to reconnect all this fuel. Oh, and there we go, Stefniki Man, MD42 holding up the German advance over there. Although it looks to be a bit of an awkward position there. Bodies is in. I've got the cramp in my leg, it hurts. Oh well.
Sector is secured.
Sniper adding in there for cruzz. There you go, munitions secured as well. And we see here that cruzz seems to be falling a bit back with MD42 in fact needing moving forwards with it. And we're noting mechanized support. Another usage of mechanized support here. Sniper's adding away, but again, it's going to be a bit hard to sort of just breach through here because the command bugger will just keep reinforcing things. I mean, he'll bleed away, but he won't force Captain Obvious to pull back. Looks like he's trying to hunt down that sniper. It's going to come in a bit on fire here. Stefniki wants more back inside the scout car. Though this time around, he's actually merged some contracts with the squad. So he doesn't have to miss much. There we go, gun. It is getting flanked here. Cruzz setting up for flanking the MD42. Well, you might be seeing rifle grenades going in response. No, pinned before that, and again, it's what around from the other side. Oh, rifle grenade did go off. Ooh, bad situation there for Cruzz. He might have extended his penal to MD. At the same time, assault going up in the center. Scout car charging straight into the MD crew. And the grenades must be a panther fast, of course. MD can still be enforced. MD retreats. MD crew barely there. Eventually, to fold the grenades. Contact's moving in. Can he hold on? No Molotov so far. Medic upgrades up, by the way, and then go just been forcing here the command bunker, giving Captain Obvious a strong position here by the center. In fact, seeing for the cruzz is being forced to fall back due to it. In fact, where he could have been otherwise been forcing Captain Obvious to retreat instead. What he was happening again, that basically Captain Obvious stood fast due to the presence of the command bunker. So a good choice there by Captain Obvious, and we are seeing a Mittler, no, not a Mittler Schütze Panzer, this is actually the 250-7 mortar half training up, meaning he's gone for spearhead doctrine. And he's falling back likely to the command bunker. While we do see some consequences moving up the left flank. Guards, riflemen have arrived here for cruzz, and we are seeing the DP light machine guns being added to further boost their firepower for the Soviet cause. Captain Obvious here, though, might be making his MG crew a bit too obvious in the face of enemy sniper fire. Mortar half track they're firing away, they cannot hit an F-Wagen. And we're seeing an S-mine fill up here by the center munitions point. Oh! Oh no, cruzz is running into it! S-mines there pop up! Only doing light damage, killing no one. Which can happen with the S-mines. And going for the fuel point over there, at the same time the fuel point over here is falling to the Russian drive connect goes off, fails to connect. Pushing up here the center, a rather heavy assault going in there. Lots of infantry supported by the sniper at the same time. Though looks like there's nothing to really stop it. That's no MG, no nothing. Only a few squads here. And the mortar half-tracks have gone out in there for Wagen. Helmut took a shot. Grenades going off as well. First of pushing the Germans out into the open. Gaspin shoots out of there. Fire with the light machine guns pulling back towards the command bunker to establish defensive position there. MD42 moving up should probably sit up there or somewhere closer. In fact, we're down on nerds in here. The Captain Obvious is rather spread out. Rifle grenades managed to push back. They strafe Nikki alongside the MD42. And he's not holding up too well, but again, command bunker gives them that increased presence. And again, ensures that Captain Obvious don't have to retreat right away. Again, the command bunker proving to be quite helpful. Might want to get a minesweeper to clear out this before someone runs through it on the retreat, panics and go quickly through that place with the signs with skulls on it. Clearly that means it is safe.
Supply sector under attack.
MD42 there moving up. And noting again he's used merge with it because again it's penal troops and mana, so again if he just reinforced it, he would actually pay more than just be merging with the conscripts. So that's a little something. Oh, there you go! Retreating through the S-mine field. S-mine field, by the way, cleared out completely. And note the signs basically just vanish afterwards. So we know that. Anyways, guardsman there. Forced away. Definitely hurt. Cruising pit there. MD42 versus MD42. More target though here on the side of the Germans. And we see here that Cruz realizes this and falls back. For the fascist weaponry, tear him apart. Then it's here and reinforcing once more against command punk. Again, a Schwerpunkt effort there from Captain Obvious. definitely make it harder for Cruz to sort of push him off the field, and definitely will force him to sort of make a much larger effort to successfully pull it off. The scout car serving as a nice piece of cover there for the MG crew. Trying to go straight into the MD4, two snipers here sort of sneaking about, trying to avoid the mortar rounds going in, and we're seeing a large infantry horseman up the right flank. Tank people, tank command going up for Cruz, and time to pop over to Captain Obvious, obviously. Mortar half tech continues to fire, moving up there towards the central munitions point. The Cruz force there advancing on the right flank. Mortar tech continues to fire, and they were usually the sort of only real artillery support for the reconnaissance battalion, since this was the reconnaissance half-track mount. There was also one for the 251 half-track. The generally such a larger panzer gunner unit would also usually have some other measures of self-propelled artillery support, usually in the form of the Grille. No, not the Grille. Oh wait, it was the Grille. I was, for some reason, confusing it with the Vespa, but it was basically a sort of light artillery, well, heavy artillery piece of sort of heavy infantry gun caliber, sort of support things on the move. They'd usually have about two per battalion. Strafniki here versus the Grenadiers. Grenadiers are not in a good position by the way out in the open. And there goes Strafniki moving up. Well, conscripts now apparently having trumped up on charges. Your uniform is out of place, Strafniki. Anyways, they're going straight at the Grenadiers and the Pioneers forcing the way. But a Panzer squad moving in from the other side forces him to collapse this position and pull back here. In the meanwhile, further fighting up here. Sniper veterans one continues to kill away, pluck away, slowly drain away. And at the same time, a force moving up the MD crew there. Guarding the flank here, ready in case that Captain Obvious tries to intervene. Nice. Oh, and then he moves it, then he moves it. Oh, bad timing right there from Cruz. Bad timing. And looks like he's got some mindset as well. Good move. And the Grenadiers managed to get past it. In fact, they gained veterancy three, but now we're encountering the Guards infantry with a DPs. MB4 setting up to cover there. Grenadiers have to be careful. If they stay back beyond this patch of veterans, they'll get gunned down. And question is, what sort of armor will Cruz get? He could get a T-70 right now and apply a bit of pressure. Of course, he might be aiming for the T-34. We do see a Pack 40 moving up there for Captain Obvious. Expecting what might next be obvious is a tank, and thus getting something to deal with it. Panzers there close, getting hit by their own artillery onto Stützung. Fuel pond there secured for the motherland. And we see Grenadiers moving in, flanking at the MG42. Well played. And of course, note all the support gunners for the MG are still equipped with SVT-40s, though. So they can actually do a bit of damage to the Grenadiers. In fact, you have to be careful like that. You could actually end up losing quite a few men there to the Strafniki MG crew. And Strafniki inside here forcing the Panthers away with some nasty losses. Veteran 2, and there we go, large infantry push up. Another S-mine field up here, and this one looks to be considerably larger this time around. I'm going to guess it's about three fields worth, 2 to 3 fields. And that's going to require the minesweepers to move in there, or a tank basically driving through it. Guardsman over here, Grenadiers moving in. No armor sign, or sign of armor so far, though he might be slowly aiming for the Tiger, Tiga. There you go, T-34 pushing up the center, MG-42 under fire, but Pack 40 provides nice countering fire, and there's a horse pulls up behind the hedgerows. Minesweepers in the center. And there we go. Grenades doing a nice bit of damage there. Victory point, they're falling. Cruz moves up here, ignores the fuel point, cuts it off for the time being. T-34 moves in there, might be able to get the half-track, but no, instead force support back there. So Panzerfaust goes off, forcing just quickly vulnerable to the Panzer Mechanone. MG42 still remaining there. Conscript snipers could move in here and flank. In fact, the Pack 40 could be in trouble, interesting enough. Cruz did not rush in here with a larger force, and something went kaboom. Somewhere. Something went splat. Oh, an S-mine field right here caught the entire guards unit. Oh, that's just terrible. Looks like a larger one on top of that. S-mine certainly had become a lot more powerful. But right here, Conscript rather close in the zone 2 to Captain Obvious. Needs to be careful. He doesn't get hit by a mortar round and suddenly suffers a huge loss. Command Banger, they're providing a constant presence there, but that was really, that's one of the slight dangers now of the new S-mine fields. They can absolutely devastate a squadron retreat, unlike the German or the Soviet mines, who can only, you know, really kill you if you're moving into them, but not retreating into them. Slight difference there. And they go getting the fuel point, in fact, getting fuel domination. They're still, again, Captain Obvious increasingly looking like he's going for the Tiger tank.
Yes, we have the sector.
Troops are enforcing. MG42 moving up. Got incendiary pieces of ground now available. That could help there against the Grenadiers or any other units that might feel cheeky. Oh, there we go. Mine went off. Boris is dead.
We are ready.
Grenadier suffering a bit like them. Medusa in the tent of Grenadier on the path. Ooh, doesn't quite succeed. Skrafniki get close and force away the Grenadiers with a fire and shots. Cruzz here slightly making a mistake in the moving in. Fortunately, we see Grenadiers upgrade with light machine guns. T-34 moving in there. Pack 40 pulling back. Now you're going to deal with these pants because they're taking back the fuel. MG42 up. He should go for incendiary armor piercing rounds. He's opening up the Pioneers and the Grenadiers. Veterani 2 up, increasing active suppression further. Mortar check blasting away. Pack 40 falling back further. Skrafniki moving in here. Captain Obvious under quite a bit of pressure. Kantik's moving. I'm seeing a second T-34 here. That should actually give him a chance here to sort of basically barge his way in here. Get the Pack 40 and the Mortar check right now if he makes his move. And then now being rounds, they're really tearing apart the conscripts at point blank. Cruzz needs to fall back there. But looks like he's buying time here. Oh, Satchel charge off on the MU42. And he got it. Cruzz got it, but he lost the Skrafniki in return to Grenadiers caught with MGs there. And now we're seeing lots of MGs on Captain Obvious. Grenadiers conscripts in his retreat. Oh dear, he lost two squads in a row. Two light machine guns in both cases. He might have, you know, slightly extended his lack. Of course, one should not underestimate the light machine gun Grenadiers. And sadly, the T-34s were nowhere to be seen to support his infantry. So right now, Cruzz has suffered quite a blow. He's still got the veteran two snipers there, sort of, you know, dealing damage and plucking away at German lives. But really, two squads, including those veteran two Skrafniki, that will hurt. That will hurt a lot. Had he been able to save those Skrafniki at the very least, things might have looked a lot different. But again, I think, you know, around that stage, a T-34 assault right here would probably turn things over completely. But seems like Cruzz is rather worried about something from Captain Obvious. And then he's... Oh, God! The sniper as well! Oh, good lord! Those are some absolutely devastating losses right there for Cruzz. He's down to two T-34s and a few infantry squads.
That's everyone! Grenadiers right!
That is bad right there. That mortar attack really did a number there on Cruzz. T-34s are rolling in. They could overwhelm this position now. There's still a time. There's still time. Pack 40 in trouble. Mortar attack in trouble. Popping smoke there. Entering heat getting moving. Reducing your force moving up their pants with MG42 up close. Bad situation. Can he stop them? And there you go. Pack 40 down. MD42 might be next. Panzers, they're forced away. The Skrafniki support gun has actually did the trap there again. Two SVT, or five SVT-40s really can do a lot of damage to Panzers. MD42 forced to fall back there. Tiger getting close, but there's a pack. Oh, he wrecked the pack 40 as well. Cruzz managing a bit of a reversal here. And there's so many. Oh, there we go. Bombing strike, can he get some units? Sadly he did not, otherwise that would have been absolutely game over out there. Still, he's about to lose the command bunker. Cruzz is regaining most of the map. Mimes are beginning to clear up that huge S minefield there. Fresh sniper team arriving. He's also got plenty of fuel, so he should consider another tank. I think also, I believe it's time for the mid-game analysis. Current situation is rather now that Cruzz, although having suffered rather intense infantry losses, still pushing back. He's doing a lot of damage there, clearing up bunkers and pack 40s, leaving currently Captain Obvious a bit open. Like, at the same time, it seems like Captain Obvious is going for the obvious choice from his perspective, a Tiger tank. A schwerer Panzer. They're sort of hold up, and again, I mean, versus two T-34s, there's a chance they're certainly holding up, but at the same time, I mean, if one rams it from the right angle, that's game over, although currently there's only really one T-34 capable of that out of the two. It's not completely terrible yet. Not yet, anyways. MD-42 over here as well. And trying to, I mean, Summoning Guardsmen, what he needs to now get their tag, but he also needs to keep it properly supported. He should either tech up, get some Panzer support out, or he needs to get some packs out or some Panzer, because he needs something extra, because the Tiger on its own will be very vulnerable against larger hordes of T-34s, so again, he will also be able to do some damage, but again, there's a chance of ramming, and in fact, that's really going to be one of those primary issues and primary worries, I would say. So that's really it, and he sort of needs to sort of regain some composure right now. Again, I mean, he's losing territory all over the place, but again, I mean, those rapid three losses in a row, though, really has given him a decent chance of coming back at this stage of the fight. I mean, had he not gotten those, I mean, things would have been looking a lot less pleasant. For cruzz, I mean, he needs to rebuild his forces. He should also consider getting another tank, and I mean, at this stage, he probably ought to have an idea. There's a chance of a Tiger tank arriving. He's going to need more T-34s for that. Then again, he could be, you know, saving up here for the ISU-152 as well. That could also prove to be a nice and devastating choice that will require a lot of resources. And for that match, you know, again, that's going to require at least two fuel points under control for some time, possibly in a fuel cache, to sort of speed that up, because otherwise, again, we're about looking at about, you know, 5 to 6 minutes, which, again, currently, that tie is going to be arriving a lot sooner before that. Otherwise, he needs more infantry. He needs to replace some of all those losses. And he might also want to save up for a Mark vehicle besides the ISU-152. I mean, those two combined can, you know, quickly lock down most of Captain Obvious's armor. Otherwise, a few mines here and there could be nice. But back to Captain Obvious for the one more minute before we end the fight. Also, in terms of damage, I mean, things are reasonably sort of equal. In fact, I mean, we're noting here that cruzz has killed more than Captain Obvious. That's a rather rarity there. And certainly a good hallmark there for how much damage is done, and certainly some of the kills have probably been inflicted by mines. Damage again rather equal, so again, cruzz has a chance of coming back, but at the same time, I mean, those three losses in tight row there again, partly probably because things happen a bit too fast, you know, has given Captain Obvious a chance of getting back the game. Anyways, holding up here, he's bringing the T-34 from this angle, likely going to have to catch that mortar after. T-34 falling back there. Can he get the gun out in that bargain? There we go. One hit. Oh, can he move it? Can he get away? Can he get away? Popping smoke. Good. Pioneer dead. Dort. Sniper moving up. And Tiger bereit there from the SSVA Panzerabteilung. 502. Rolling ahead there. Sniper's falling back. Heavily wounded. Alive and empty, they're sort of trying to fall back. Can he set up in the right time? Can the grenadiers be stopped? They go caught out in the open, and with SVT-40s firing in on them, they're actually in a very bad position. In fact, Veteran 22 there could easily end up the kick getting pinned. There we go, Rav Grenade goes off, Rav Grenade goes off, T-34 again there to assist. Tiger tank slowly advances, but carefully, he knows there's T-34s around here. One wrong move and he can end up rather in a lot of trouble. That grenadier's pinned. Forge retreat. Tiger moving out. Guardian is fresh caught there, coming under fire. And mines going off. Oh! Looks like an is well wiped out in retreat there. T-34 set off the mines by shooting at it. Oh! Looks like Captain Obvious S mines bit him in the arse. Looks like he might be setting up for a ram on the Tiger's rear. Can he pull it off? Mortar for there coming under fire. Certainly could also try and getting that. That could also prove to be quite helpful. Clouds are getting it. Veteran 2 on the T-34. Veteran 2, there we go. Half tank down. Tiger tank taking heavy damage. He's still some time off from a marked vehicle. T-34 needs to fall back. Doing nice damage to the Tiger. Fall back, fall back. Oh, another damage engine on this T-34. Heavy engine damage. More S-mines going off. Oh no, he's going to ram it. He's going to ram it. But quickly they're closing the gap, ensuring that doesn't happen. More S-mines going off. Guard seems to be running into a lot of trouble here. Cruzz getting overwhelmed. Too much going on for him to manage. Sniper's moving up. Comedy's moving in. Can he save that veteran 2 T-34 or will it be lost? Sniper's over there. Panzergun is dead. He's still containing Captain Obvious nicely, but again the losses are getting rather heavy and rather hairy. But two more minutes, he's got the fuel for the ISU-152, and he'll soon also have the manpower. This T-34, though, is gone. There we go, kaput. Kaput. This MG42 crew, by the way, has done crucially quite well. Cruz. Oh, he's getting another T-34. I really think you're just trying to save up for that RU-152. That really could have the chance then, particularly with marked vehicle. Then again, the two T-34s with the guards in the squad and marked vehicle could also turn the time on the Tiger. That's going to be a lot more tricky, I think. Snipers continue that pressure there. Replacing the command bunker most likely. Tiger there opening up, forcing the snipers back. Needs to be careful there. There goes second T-34 arriving there for Cruz. And looks like someone got themselves a DP. Panzer was there under sniper fire as well. There we go, command bunker.
Your predecessor for a hero at your service. Enemy infantry firing on me.
And these snipers need to get the devil out of there. There we go, Grenadiers under fire. T-34's advancing. Veteran 2 and non-veteran. Of course, the Veteran 2 with high rate of fire and more damage. Grenadiers are all getting wiped out already. Panzer Gunners are caught out in the open. T-34 fires and fails to hit. T-34 moving out in the open. Needs to pull back. He's trying there to get the kill on the Grenadiers. Nice move, but exposed himself there to the Tiger's 88mm gun. Two comments up, both of the minesweepers. And then advancing straight down to them. Not entirely sure what Cruz is thinking with that. Not entirely sure what he's thinking with that.
The enemy has taken our supply sector.
T-34s need to pull back. MG42 and Conscript's getting suppressed. He's leaving up the left flank as well, so he's got a disadvantage to take back. If only he had the RU-152 right here, he probably could have done a lot more damage, particularly in conjunction with marked vehicle. MG42 needs to retreat. Come on, Cruz. So close to Veteran T3. So close. Come on, Cruz, just retreat.
We are targets! One standing by!
But he seems a bit reluctant to do that. T-34's watch mounting repairs. And Veterans 1 snapping away there.
Stand there! Move! We are ready!
Might pop a grenade there, I suppose. Okay. Then again, saving up munitions. In fact, looks like he might be saving up for another bombing strike. Interesting, interesting. Also getting close to the RU-152. He could try and combine the two with the T-34s.
In contact with enemy infantry.
I mean, there's an option there. I mean, he could try ramming the Tiger tank, calling a bombing strike, then have the RU-152 fire away at it at the same time, sort of forming an overall nasty kill strike that might have a chance of success. Although at the same time, he might be seeing here CaptainObvious getting out, and he's calling in the bombing strike. Oh, he should have waited. Cruz getting a bit eager, I think. In the end, not even getting the command bunk. I mean, that was a bit wasted. He should have waited, I feel. That was a bit of a waste there of 200 munitions. And again, I mean, he might as well then just saved up for marked vehicle. And again, with the RU-152, I mean, that and the two T-34s could really have done the number on that Tiger tank, because again, it basically needs more damage. In conjunction with, say, the Veteran 2 T-34s, well, I mean, that really could have turned that part. And he's going in with the MG crew there. Oh dear. Mine's up there. Good, good.
We're under attack.
Short of fuel.
We have taken it.
And getting close to this one with Veteran T-3.
To bring destruction.
Sturmovik needs a target.
So close. So is a CaptainObvious getting to that obvious sniper. Panzergun is there with two puncher strikes. T-34's moving in. Bombarding the fascists. With high explosive rounds, they're getting one fascist. Tiger shoots and misses. Panzerx fires, one connects. Sniper's adding a few shots there. T-34 getting an RC8 there. Comet's getting overwhelmed by Grenadiers. Larger force from up the left flank. Guard infantry might want to win support.
Enemy forces are neutral.
Just a few more seconds. Close veteran TV there and a further increased rate of fire. And now we've got RU-152 available.
Units awaiting orders.
Shadow Boy, Beast Killer arriving. Based on the IS challenges, there was in fact an SU-152 before. Less high velocity gun was also based on the KV chassis, but otherwise overall same idea. You need light anti-tank support. Just overall less powerful. Cruise KMG up as well. Sadly not enough vision for a marked vehicle. He could focus up then and have the T-34 support it. Mine went off there. Veteran D3 on the MG and oh, shot failed to penetrate. What a damn shame right there. Nope, the IG-152 has quite the range. Fails to miss. Come on, Yuri, you've got really big guns. Shoot them. Wow. That's just terrible. Veteran D3, there we go. Further increased rate of fire, but also increased speed. Tiger pulls back, and there we go. A second Tiger arrives. Now things might be looking less well there for Cruz. Trying to catch those Panzer guns. They need to be careful about other things arriving now from the other flanks. Looks like a larger Tiger assault is inbound here from Captain Obvious. Two Tigers moving in.
Fresh guards, troops are
veteran DT-54, and we're seeing another guard squad arriving here. Tiger moving up on the other side. T-34 moving in there. He's spreading them up. Splitting them up.
Incoming shitstorm.
Bunker under fire. Need to target that Tiger. Mark vehicle by the same time. We've got the Tiger over here as well. Situation's getting very ugly. Oh, the end of focus sights. Oh no. Things go completely wrong here for Cruz. Things go completely wrong. This IG-152 is completely outmaneuvered here by the Tiger. The other Tiger might be in slight trouble, but without, you know, marked vehicle, it's certainly not as bad off as it could be. Lots of guardsmen firing away. IG-152 trying to escape the raft here. Veterans on the Tiger. Successfully rammed one Tiger, but there's still the Veteran 2 on the rampage there. He could button it, but it's too late,
We have lost one of our armored vehicles.
Armored tank, get in the shit down!
Firing in their anti-tank rifles wildly into the side of the Tiger. Doing little damage on another some of the Veteran 2. They do have increased chance of penetrating the rear armor.
We are dying here.
We have an isolated
and Cruz getting a bit upset here. Pretty much GG here, so I'll just stop. We don't have to see all the rest of that. Overall, though, well played by both sides, but Cruz kept making a few mistakes here and there. I kind of feel the bombing strikes, in particular with a huge weight of munitions. No attempt for some marked vehicle, which is definitely unfortunate. I think that again could have helped him get down those Tigers, you know, marking vehicle again, forcing Cruz to actually be much more conservative around even T-34s as the damage output would noticeably increase, in particular with support from the Guards Riflemen. In that regard, you know, I mean, overall, he had a lot of units which weren't working together well, could actually, you know, even force the Tigers to be, you know, rather cautious, even prudent, but it never quite happened. I mean, there was no real say, you know, T-34s coordinating with guardsmen to, for example, you know, take it out at once. Also, I think, you know, he shouldn't have wrecked that PAC-40. I think he should have stolen it. Had he done that again, he would be a much stronger choice. And I'm certainly surprised, you know, he didn't seem to prepare as much for the Tiger as he could have. And, of course, came the IG-152. Again, he should have coordinated that with the T-34s a bit better. I mean, trying to ram it, you know, even starting it, and then perhaps a bombing strike, you know, just marked vehicle would probably have left him with a lot better chances. But at that stage, it just seemed like he was falling apart mentally as well as in terms of army-wise, which was definitely unfortunate. Because, I mean, the guard rifle certainly did well, but again, it was also those three losses in a rapid row that really did it in for him. I'm not entirely sure why it happened. In some cases, you know, just, you know, incendiary bombing run, or incendiary mortar round, just wiping that. But otherwise, you know, it seems like he was just a bit too slow to retreat, which rather cost him. But even then, I mean, the Strafniki MG here certainly did quite well, gaining Veteran Z3. Don't underestimate that. Don't. And certainly a question it could also be, if perhaps he should have just back-checked to support Wem Company and got himself some field guns to help as well. I mean, that is definitely also an option. But I think rather than problem again was basically for some reason he seemed reluctant or had a problem chaining all things together to, you know, take down that tiger. Because again, I mean, that one tiger had them been taken down quicker, you know, the other tiger certainly wouldn't have had much of a chance either. And that will be game over for Captain Obvious. And certainly Captain Obvious was a bit lucky there with those three squawk wipes in a row. But, you know, he managed to take advantage of it. And sure, you know, Cruzz couldn't bounce back from it easily. Though again, Cruzz with those two T-34s did a lot of damage. But he could probably have done a lot more in some regards. And again, that Pack 40 probably should have been recaptured. I mean, those are a lot of thoughts. But, you know, the IG-152 definitely could have been used a lot better, I think, and certainly guarded better. But instead, you know, he completely lost and his set made it an easy target for his opponent. Which is certainly unfortunate. For Captain Obvious, I mean, you know, he used this, this, and this sort of alright. But, you know, some reconnaissance overflight or a fragmentation bomb could have been nice. He certainly had some problems here and there, certainly got hit. Some beat ups there from Cruzz certainly began bleeding out. The MD42 in particular proving a bit nasty. Also, surprisingly, didn't use incendiary armor putting rounds as an MD42 there, Mr. Cruzz. The sniper certainly also doing quite a number, but in the end, the Tiger tanks and his preservation of them and the mistakes that Cruzz made rather prevailed in the end. Though, again, another question might have been, you know, if he just shouldn't have teched up and gotten some regular Panzers. Definitely also thought that the command bunker, by the way, you know, also quite nice, certainly. Sort of limited the effect the sniper had in terms of pushing back his forces, allowing him to maintain a strong point there, and that definitely also helped Cruzz a bit at bay and certainly, you know, gave Captain Obvious a lot more resilience than he otherwise might have had in this fight. But now, of course, here, compared to the mid-game, I mean, things really went south there for Cruzz. A lot more damage than inflicted, though again, he's actually still in the lead in terms of kills, which is actually rather interesting to note. S-mine still right. They wiped one squad, that was it really here, but otherwise, you know, they basically just forced Cruzz to be a lot more careful and bring in minesweepers, or, you know, have to maneuver around rather carefully, but he didn't lose that much more beyond, again, that one squad. That also hurt Cruzz, that also hurt. No doubt about that, but I mean, well played by both, but again, Cruzz making a few mistakes, not capitalizing on some of his own strength, in some cases, sort of quickly overwhelmed the Tigers before they managed to bring in more numbers. Rather in the end hurt him, and again I think those bombing strikes perhaps should have been a bit more well thought out. Anyways, this is Imperial Dane saying cheers, hope you enjoyed this episode, hope you learned some things or two, perhaps even about, you know, using the Strafniki, which again I do feel an underappreciated unit in this game. If not, you know, send in a replay on your own, provide some feedback in the comments. If you did, you know, subscribe, share with everyone, you know, tell your friends, like it and so on, favorite even. And, you know, let me know in the comments, that's always great. As well, this is Imperial Dane saying cheers, and see you tomorrow, you wonderful people.